Hello and welcome to the class of Theory of Computation. I am Mrs. Pragati Mahale, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Information Technology at AISSMS Institute of Information Technology, Pune. Today we shall see the Unit 4 of Theory of Computation, which refers to the push-down automata study. So, we have seen the hierarchy of languages which are recognized in the subject of TOC. In our earlier unit, we have studied finite state machines, and we know that the finite state machines are recognized by the regular languages. They are expressed using regular expressions. So, today we are going to study push-down automata, and the push-down automata, they are recognized by this second hierarchy of languages, that is context-free languages, which are defined using a context-free grammar. So let us see the introduction of push-down automata. So push-down automata, it is more powerful than the finite automata that we have studied. Any language which can be accepted by the pushdown finite automata are also recognized by finite pushdown automata. This is one thing. Secondly, the pushdown automata also it recognizes all the classes of language which cannot be accepted by the finite automata. We have seen in while studying finite automata, there are certain restrictions on some languages which are not recognized by finite automata due to certain limitation of memory which is not there in finite automata. So we say that the push down automata is more powerful and superior to the finite automata. So basically, a push-down automata, we can say it is a combination of a finite state machine with a stack. So the added stack increases the capability of the machine. It provides the push-down automata with a memory. A push-down automata, it has three components. The first component is the input tape. The second is the control unit, and the third is the stack with the infinite size. So the stack, there is a stack head which scans the top symbol of the stack. So this is how the components of the push down automata can be represented. So we have the input tape, we have the stack, we have a finite control unit, and which is responsible to read or push or pop the input symbols from the input tape into the stack based on the various stack operation, and at the end it depending upon the language it may accept or reject the string for which we have designed our push down automata. So as this the stack is involved in the push down automata, it comes with two operations. The first operation is the push operation. Whenever a new symbol is added to the top of the stack, we say we push the symbol. Similarly, the pop, the top symbol is read and removed. So the PDA may or may not read an input symbol, but it has to read the top of the stack. So it is the top of the stack which is considered in every transition. Apart from push and pop, the stack is also there is another operation associated with the stack, is to check the empty condition of the stack through the initial stack symbol. Z0 is the symbol which we consider to be there in the stack, which indicates the stack is empty. Also, in some book, a dollar symbol is represented to is used to represent the condition of the stack. Now, let us see the formal definition of the PDA. So the PDA is represented using the seven tuples, like we represent our finite atometer using five tuples. So these are the seven tuples for the PDA. Let us see each and every element of this tuple. So Q is my first element, and it represents the finite set of states. Then I have the finite input alphabet. This is the sigma, indicates the set of finite input alphabet. Then I have gamma symbol, that is the finite stack alphabets. Then I have Q0, which indicates the initial or the starting state. So Q0 is nothing but the set subset of our set of states. Then we have Z0, which is the starting stack symbol, and it remains at the bottom of the stack. Then we have F, that is the set of final states. Again, it is a subset of Q. And the delta is the transition function, which is represented as Q into the, this is the set of input where which is the also the union of the empty string and all the finite stack alphabets, and this leads to a new state with a new input push onto the stack. So this represents our transition function. We will see the transition function in detail in the next. So transition function is represented in push down atto in this following in this following way. So we can this represents the transition diagram with some state. Okay, so we can say this is the initial state Q0, and this is the another state on which we go to upon the transition function. Let us assume that this is Q1 state. So over this transition, we are writing a kind of transition function. This transition function consists of three symbols. So it consists of the current state transition in PDA depends upon the current state, the current input, and the top of the stack. Okay, so and this label here indicates the input symbol. This is the current input. Then B here indicates which is the top of the stack. At the stack, what is the topmost symbol currently? And this C indicates that this is the new symbol which is to be pushed onto the stack. So this is the transition diagram with the label, and we are transitioning from the state Q1 to state Q2. Okay. Now, also we can see that in some book the notation for the transition diagram is shown in this fashion. So this is now we can say a general transition from the QI state to some QJ state, and this represents my current state, whereas QJ represents my next state. This is A represents my current input symbol, whereas X represent my top of the stack, means this what is on my top of the stack. Okay. And upon transition, okay, once we carry out the transition, what happens is this X, which is on the top of the stack, upon transition we move to the new state, like here. So P here, as you can see in this transition with this stack operation, so we reach from Q to the P state, and we have at the input tape, the current input is A. Currently on the top of the stack is X, and upon carrying out the transition, we move to the new state, that is the state P, and we have replaced this symbol x with the new symbol y. So this is my current new top. So where x is replaced with y upon this transition function upon receiving a input from the input tape. This is how we read this transition function defined by push down automata. So to generalize the transition function, like we have one state q, and upon certain inputs we are moving to different states. So this again to revise, q is my current state and current input symbol is not considered, so it is epsilon or empty string, and z indicates the top of the stack. We are moving to the next state, that is p1, and we are pushing the new symbol on the top of the stack, that is gamma 1. So we replace z with gamma 1. Okay, so and there is no input symbol to read. This epsilon means there is no input symbol. So this represents the transition function of PDA. Thank you.